Hello everyone, I am Rajesh from Asian Technology. We are learning complete Python course from beginners to advanced level. Last class we learned how to ask user his name and password, his name, first name and second name, and the print out, right? So this is not a proper way ask user. In first name is first line and second name in second line. So I am going to ask user multiple input in single line. So let me start and teach you. So just I'm going to remove this code. So I'm going to ask user a multiple, right? So before ask user, let me create multiple variable in single line. So for variable, you know, variable means just name equals to some name, right? Maybe Rajesh, and the maybe first name real underscore name Yadav, right? So this is not a proper way. We can create these two in the same line. So let me tell you how. First, and separate comma, okay? L underscore name. So I am going to same way, very easy. First name means this is going to assign in first name, and the separate comma, full name, last name, Yadav. So this Yadav is going to assign in L name. So this is a way how we create multiple variable in single line. Even you can create age if you like, if you need age. Also age is integer, right? So you don't have to put a double quote, between double quote. Just write whatever you want. So let me full name. Full name means L underscore name plus L underscore name, right? So I can print. Full name is not the full name. Now is full name, right? So let me print. I think you guys understand everything. UI dot UI. You see, Rajesh Yadav, right? It's very easy. The same thing, I just create a variable in single line, nothing else. And add a and full and the first name and last name, assign full name and the output. So this is how to create multiple variable in single line, right? But today we are going to learn how to ask user multiple input in a single line. So I'm not going to change this one. I'm just going to use this one. So just same like this. Let's say here, if you want to ask user to input, right, you have to write input, correct? Just same way, tell user please enter your first name and the comma and the also last name, understand? And the now is not complete, this is just a single input. But I want multiple input, right? Means more than. I'm going to delete this one. Age. If you need, also okay. Let me show you. Age also need. So I'm going to ask user input what first name, last name, and also age. So also I'm going to write here also age. Understand, right? I'm going to ask user. I'm going to tell user to enter first name, last name and age in a single line. So if you want to ask ask user to input in single line, you have to write here dot split. Dot split means in a single line. And one more thing here, please just use double quote, and the first name and second name means last name you want to separate with this, right, comma. So you have to write here comma. Also you can able to tell user here and separate with comma, understand, right? If you want to, you can tell separate with comma, that then user can understand this. Let me run and show you, then you understand everything here. First see here, please enter first name and last name and age, and they separate with comma, right? Then user know the first name and the separate with comma, and last name and separate with comma, also age 39, enter. Now you can see I just print first name and last name right here. But if you want to print also age, so you know right how to print age, just add here age. It's correct? What do you think? It's correct? No, because this is a string here. When we ask user to input his age, the age is between double quote, right? That means the age is a string, but we need age always change into integer. So I'm going to change age into integer, right? I think you know. Last class we already learned how to change in integer. So now here age is integer, but we need age is string, right? So again I have to change into string. Get it? Okay. See here. First, when we ask user to input his age, that time user going to input in between double quote. That means user going to input age as a string. Why? Because inside double quote, right? But age always we have to change into string. So this is a way how we change age into string, right? I think you know. If you don't know, please try to watch last video and you understand. So age is now here. Now here age is integer, right? But age, when you're going to add with a string, because the full name is string. Why? See, first name and last name is come from here, right? And the string, and because name is always string, so name is string here, so full name also is string. So that means the full name is here is string, so you cannot add integer to string, right? So this is integer. I'm again going to change integer into string. And last time I told you why we need to change here integer, right? So let me print again. First name I'm going to Rajesh, separate comma. Second name Yadav, separate comma. And my age 47. Enter. You see first name and second name and 47, right? Means age is 47. So this is the way how we tell user to input. I think it's very easy and you guys understand very well, right? And let me ask tell user to input his birthday. Last time how we did. Birthday. Then I'm going to 2018 minus his age. And this now is not here. Now here is this one, right? B day. So see here now, user going to enter input his birthday, and this birthday is going to assign in B day, right? And B day here is a string, so I'm going to change here integer. So now is 2018 minus his birthday, and his real age. And now I'm going to print his real age. So let me try again here. Let me clear first. Again, run Python UI.py. Name, first name Rajesh, separate comma, and Yadav, separate comma, birth date 90/80/47. Anything what you want. See here, Rajesh Yadav, and here 47. If you want to between these two, have a bit space. Please here, just add one double quote and a space and add here plus. So now between first name the name and the age have one string, right? And that string is just a space, nothing else. So let me show you again. And also if you need first name and second name some separate, you also can here do here, but I'm not going to do that. First name Rajesh comma Yai, and the my birthday may be 56. Now you see first name Rajesh and the second name Y, what I input here, and my age is, you see, 32. As you can write here, your age, right? As you can write here, your full name is the space and plus. I think you guys understand, right? Here your full name, and here your age, and here. This is, you already know because we already did in last class how to print this one, right? So let me show you again. First name, address, separate comma, Yadav, separate comma, and the age 9060. I don't know what. Just I'm printer. You see here. But age is never going to become more than 75, 80, maybe 90, maybe 100, right? So this is not a correct. So we will make sure in future, in next class, how we change these things. We're not going to print more than 100. So for today, I think is enough. Today you guys have just have to know how to ask user to input multiple input in a single line. And these things already we know, we learn already learn in last class, right? So today is just new, only one thing, only this, and only in single line, nothing else. So this is a nice way and proper way how we do. And next class we are going to learn more, and we are going to print this one at a different way and a very nice way. So see you in next class. Stay tuned. Goodbye.